Hey, Rain Sunshine, how are you? Hey, everybody, how are you doing? This is a dog we're going to be working with right now. We're just going to be doing a small counter conditioning protocol for a growling dog with huge bite potential. He has not bitten yet because he's not had the opportunity. But doing this for a really long time, he is your perfect example of a small dog that bites. And unfortunately, the owner and the owner's family might have something to do with it, to contribute it. I don't say that to shame her. She's sitting right in front of me. I say it because she's learning a ton of stuff today. A lot of great information. She is a shelter volunteer. Worker, big difference. She's actually paid help at a shelter, and she has definitely a lot of, okay? Cool, all right. So we're gonna start in a little bit, and Mike is good. He's definitely a cute dog. He's cute. Yeah, that's the problem, is they're cute, and when they growl, we pick them up. Or when they growl, we cuddle them. Or when we growl, we tell them it's okay. Hey, hola, ¿cómo está? How are you? Yeah, he's a really cute dog. So what's going to happen is everybody knows that I do a lot of Q&A. So what we're going to do is I'm going to do a protocol with this dog, and then I'm going to sit down and talk to you for about 10 minutes doing Q&A about this dog, and then also about the RV dog training seminar that I'm doing here in Maui, Hawaii. Aloha, how are you? So if you're brand new, if you don't know who I am, my name is Jeff Gellman. I'm with Solid Canine Training. I've got a training facility out in Providence, Rhode Island, and I travel the world doing dog training seminars. My dog training facility is run by 9 awesome people, 24/7, 365. They do a kick-ass job. If you like what you see, give me lots of hearts. If you don't know how to give hearts, tap on your screen and you will get hearts. In case there's a water landing, what I want you to do is go to your closest exits. Remember, your closest exits might be behind you. Water slides will disperse automatically as soon as you open the door. Also, what you can do is you can click on the little figure in the corner and you can share this on Facebook and on Twitter. Massively in love with you, and let me start a basic food protocol. Limit your questions while I'm working because Mike is holding the camera and Mike doesn't want to work too hard.
There's Mike. All right, there's Mike. He's a super great guy.
Okay. So, I'm going to want you to walk away. So you're like hanging out by the door. Okay. So, you'll see all of a sudden now, there's a level of the dog being frantic, right? So all of a sudden the dog gets frantic. Growling is starting. So growling is starting. If I try to touch the dog, he's super wary, okay? He's super wary of human touch, super nervous around human touch. So what we're gonna do is this. The only way this little guy is going to eat for 2 weeks would be through this protocol. Okay? So. Uh-oh. Somebody's not hungry enough. Jasmine, will you go outside and find that treat bag that I have? It might be it could be inside on the snack table. It might also be outside, inside that red bag, that luggage piece of mine. It's the thing I had around my waist, okay? So we normally don't use any treats for this. It's a counter conditioning food advocacy protocol where the only way this dog eats for 2 weeks is through physical touch. Now, what happens is, if the dog's not hungry enough, he can go without. But when they're really, really hungry, the only way that he's gonna do it is he's gonna get physical touch from me, and then he's gonna get some food. See how he's shying away from me? I'm actually gonna bring him in closer to me, and he's growling the whole time. So, he's not hungry enough. We don't like to use treats, but I've got the camera rolling, and I gotta show you guys something. So I just sent Jasmine, who's the dog's owner, downstairs. Mike, you wanna show him the pool area? Give him a quick thing of the pool area.
Awesome, thank you. And he will put this on YouTube.
Okay. Okay, so let's see what we can do with these.
So use food now instead of bought treats.
Yep. So now what I'm using is these grain-free little peanut things. And so what I'm doing is, good. So I'm gonna start out, good. Good. So now I'm starting out doing food first, good. Then what we do is we do touch first, good, and then food. Now, the dog is at the end of the leash. I am delivering the food to the dog. So the dog is as far as on the leash as possible. So what I'm doing is I'm going to touch the dog, good, and then give the dog food. So earlier today when I tried to touch this dog, if it was not on a leash, it would have run to the upper 48, swam right across the water and everything, all right? If you're just tuning in, my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. I'm a real-world dog trainer. I've got a training facility in Providence, Rhode Island. If you like what you're seeing, give me lots of hearts. By the way, this Periscope, guys, is gonna get me over 1 million hearts. This is my 101st Periscope. I've been on for less than 2 months, and because of all of you, I've reached 1 million hearts. All that means is that I'm bringing you guys tremendous value. So this is you. This is all your work, and I'm super proud of you. Little character in the corner, click on that. Share this on Facebook, share this on Twitter. Also, if you're not following me, you'll see my bio. Click on that, become a follower. Also, get an alert. So, touch, touch, touch. Good. Good. Touch, touch, touch. Good. Now, I'm using treats, but this is to be used for food. If a dog does, so if I use food, here's food. Okay, now that's why you don't use treats, because now the dog won't take the food. If this dog was truly hungry, it would take its food. The food would act like treats. Okay, now what we're gonna do is we went from the first step was this: food first, then touch, good. I did that a few times. Then we went touch first, good, food. Now we're gonna do this. If the dog was at the end of the leash, now we're gonna do this. Good. Now you gotta come to me. Okay? Now you gotta come to me. All you wanna do is run away from me, so every time I try to touch you, you would avoid, growl, lunge. And I'm keeping him on a leash because he can actually just go off this cliff here. So that might be too much. Good. Good. So now I gotta touch you and you gotta come into me. So are we starting to see the difference? So it's, you know, what a lot of times what people do is, well, when the dog growls, just throw him food. That's my like fake dog trainer voice, you know? So what I want you to do is, no, that's how you teach dogs to growl. Dog growls, food shows up. No, you don't do that. What you do is you come into me, you let me pet you, good. That's what we want. That's what we want. So food overrides fear. Hunger drive overrides fear drive, all right? So food drive is the highest drive that you can have with a dog. Good. Good. So Jasmine, turn the camera to Jasmine. Could I do this earlier today?
No.
Okay. So what normally would be happening right now with a stranger?
He'd be growling, and
tacos
would be up, and he'd be avoiding you.
Yeah, avoiding me. So now there's a level of safety. So now what do I do with my body? Now I put my body in a much more comfortable spot as well. So a little bit cautious though. So I change my body. What do? We slow it down a little bit. I'm not going to assume that he's going to do just as good of a job because I just changed my body. Because I added a new variable. I'm lower to the ground, I'm more in the dog's bubble, right? So, good. So I'll just do a couple of food protocols first, good. Right? Now, if you want this food, good. Good.
If you hear wind, I apologize. It's really windy right now. Good. Good. So imagine doing this two meals a day, one piece of kibble at a time for 3 weeks. Now the idea is that the owner can start this, but obviously the owner, the dog's not gonna have the same reaction. The owner can start the protocol, but then you wanna find other people who the dog, like, you know, you can't just ask a complete stranger to do it because they won't know the protocol. But everybody can use this protocol for a lot of different things. What's the dog's name?
K-O-A.
That's right, Cole.
Yeah.
We have a campground in there. So,
name your name?
Good.
That's Cole.
That's the wood.
Oh, yeah.
Good. 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 So, if you want to eat, you're going to let me touch it. But also, I'm not doing, you know, good is more informational. So good is from an informational standpoint. It's just marking it good, good, good. So I'm going all around, but I'm also keeping my eye on the dog. Good. I'm having the dog come right into me, right into me, right? Because I'm not gonna, you come in for your food. If you want this food, it's right there. And as a dog comes towards it, I actually even pull back.
Storage almost full.
How could that be? Okay, this might shut off, guys. I just deleted everything. All right, guys, I might stop this now and then come back for some Q&A. So I'm gonna come back. Let me just figure out why my storage unit is almost full. Jeff Gellman, Sally Canine Training, madly in love with you. We're gonna end this Periscope now, but I'm gonna be coming back on in 2 minutes. All right, love you.
Alright. Holy shit.
It's a beautiful thing. Should we get closer?
What's this flashing light for?
Where?
On the handle.
Oh, just the... It's a Bluetooth. Hey guys, people joining up?
Five.
Okay, sorry, I had to go in to dump a lot of movies off of... I delete them when I put them on my iPhone.
Mastiff, Yoda.
Hey Yoda, how are you? So this is step two. If you missed step one,
Elena.
Hey Elena, how are you? If you missed step one, go back to watch the replay of it. We're running out of storage on the phone. I just wiped out all my storage, so we have plenty of storage now. And I just put, you know, probably 10 hours of freaking video a day on this thing. All right. So if you're not familiar with who I am, my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. I'm based in Providence, Rhode Island. I've got a great training facility there. It's open 24/7, 365 as far as staffing. And we specialize in the rehabilitation of aggressive dogs, heavy behavior modification, but obviously we work with young puppies as well. And right now what I'm doing is I'm in Maui, Hawaii, doing a seminar. If you follow me on Facebook, if you don't follow me on Facebook, please follow me on Facebook. You'll see everything there. Put it this way, when my wife wants to know where I am, she goes to Facebook. And if Linda, if you're on there, you know, hey Linda, how are you? If you want to know more about Linda,
older bird.
She's obviously, you know, a kick-ass chick. So this is the dog that obviously earlier today, first of all, when this dog came here 8 hours ago, it barked at everything that moved. So Mike, give a little synopsis, because Mike's the one that chaperoned it up here.
Yeah, when all the folks showed up here with their dogs, they were all out in the street kind of milling around getting ready to come up here. And this little guy was barking at everyone, every person, every dog, everything, the whole time until they walked up to the house in about 15 or so minutes.
Yeah. So out of control. Typical nonsense we see. Then when I started working with it today, when I tried to touch it like, oh my gosh, when I tried to touch it like this, like, right? Surprise, surprise. I tried to touch it like this, it would growl. Well, first of all, when I would approach it, it would growl. Growl at me. If it didn't move backwards, say it was cornered, And if I got close, like, but I'm a dog lover, let me pet you, it would be a bite. It would be a bite. Cute dog, small dog, growly dog. Well, oh, I think I know everything about dogs. Let me come in and pet it. You get bit. So what I'm doing is I started doing a counter conditioning food protocol. I'm not going to do the whole thing because I did a lot of it, and you can watch the replay. So what I did was this, is when you use the dog's daily food, use the dog's daily food, the only way you're going to eat, the only way you're going to eat is like this. And you want to use first Jasmine, who's right there, is the owner, is she can do this first. Well, actually, I'm doing it first. I'm actually taking all the bite risk right now. Then what could happen is you can get other people to do it. So this is what you're going to do. You're going to start out slow. You're going to start out slow by just offering food. Good touch. Good. Good. So you do that 30 times. Food. Good. Real quick. And then let go. Now, then what you do is this. Then you say to the dog, well, actually, if you want this food, you're going to have to let me touch you first. So you're going to, no. This, good, and then food. Okay. And we just did this. This is all done. Like, watch the replay that we just stopped 5 minutes ago. This was all done right here on the veranda of the love boat.
Lanai.
What do they have on the love boat?
Love boat's not in Hawaii.
I know, but I'm talking
in
about
Hawaii,
the
this is a Lanai.
I know, but I'm talking about the old show from the 80s, the yep. Love Boat with Julie,
right.
The cruise director.
Yep. Gopher, got it.
Okay. Gopher, Julie.
Who's the bartender? Isaac.
Isaac?
Yeah.
Who else? Who's the captain?
Steuben.
Who's the Gilligan? Skipper. Little Buddy. No, wrong show. I'm all confused in the 80s.
Yeah.
So then, it's going to be like this. Good. Now, 5 minutes ago, I couldn't do, someone's causing trouble. Don't mess with Mike.
D-I-C-K.
Yeah. Don't mess with Mike. Okay. Mike is military, all right? So him banning you is the kindest thing he's ever done in his career, right? So, and if anybody watches my regular Periscope, the person that's filming it is CrossFit Mike, who's an awesome, awesome, did I recognize him? Good. There we go. So now, I'm going to up the pressure. Good. 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 Okay, now, we ready for this? We're going to do the two-handed, no-thumb cuddle. Good. I lied. Use my thumbs. Good. 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 Make the dog come to me now, right? Good. 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 So, maybe this isn't as impressive to others, Jasmine, who's the owner of this dog. Pan over to Jasmine.
Is this a miniature pincher mix?
Jack Russell mix.
Ooh.
Yeah.
So, impressive, not impressive, progress, no progress?
Definitely a lot of progress.
Okay.
And is he too small for an e-collar?
No, he's not. But we wouldn't use an e-collar for this work. But we e-collar train all dogs. But this is not a remote collar. God, what is this with banning people today? Jeez, how long has it been since people have done it? What am I doing?
Your junk is...
My junk?
Thrilling them.
Come on, ladies, control yourself.
No, it was Thug Life. I think it was a dude.
Oh, wow, Thug Life. There you go.
Jacks are tough. Good job. Shelter dog.
Good. Oh, good job. So that's what I was looking for. I'm looking for engagement here. Come on.
When he put his paw on you?
Yeah, he's climbing up on me. So, no, you don't want dogs climbing up on you, but that's... Oh, shh. Good. No.
Yoda wants to know what happened to your boots.
What happened to my boots? I had them on all day long. So I had my boots on all day long out in the hot sun. And obviously I wanted to dress like a local. We're in Hawaii, so I wore my boots. And that got a good laugh, obviously. So when I'm training dogs at seminars, I have to wear boots. Quiet. No. The dog actually was growling at the dog behind Jasmine. So the dog, there's a dog back there. The dog growled. So we're going to stop this now, and I'm going to do some Q&A. I'll do one more. So we went backwards. Great. Good. Good job. All right. Good job. Good job. Oh, yeah, that's a good job. There you go. All right. So I'll do some Q&A now. Ah. CrossFit Mike, Jasmine, light's good out here. What's your question?
Okay, so like you guys heard, he growled at the dogs behind.
Yes.
He was pretty good whenever I would take him out before. He played with all the dogs, and then I had a foster dog,
yes.
A pit bull. She was really great, nothing aggressive. But she got a little too playful with him and she kind of trampled him a few times.
Yes.
Could that have triggered it?
Yeah, a lot of stuff. Yeah, too much pressure on dogs, yeah. So it's sort of like, I'll go after you before you go after me.
Okay.
It's like, it's that whole thing where I'll go after you before you go after me attitude. Mm-hmm. So that's exactly what happens.
Oh.
So that's why we advocate for our dogs. So we're going to be super, super cautious. Good job. So, pretty cool stuff, huh? So, I mean, you'd think, oh, what's the big deal? But for a dog, it's always growling. Actually, it's actually a huge deal. All right, guys. So, what you can do is this. Lots of hearts, lots of hearts, lots of hearts. We actually broke a million finally. Give me lots of hearts. Also, at the corner, you can swipe and share. Are dogs capable of realizing their size difference? That's a really good question. I think attitude is more important than size. I think that I've seen plenty of small dogs run with big dogs. I've seen plenty of small dogs be the dominant dog in the pack. I have seen big, huge, powerful dogs being total wimps. So I've seen it on both sides. Does a small dog, I mean, I don't know if this dog knows that it weighs 10 pounds. I don't know that. I don't know that. I don't know that at all. Okay. So this looks just like, you know, Mike is just giving this dog food, but it's bigger than that. The dog is approaching Mike, and it's not growling. So what we're doing is we're doing a counter conditioning protocol for the dog. Oh, good for you. Awesome, Mama Hans. Congratulations. So what we're doing is we're doing a counter conditioning protocol. This dog sees humans.
Your Mastiff was scared of my mom's Chihuahua for 2 days. Yeah, exactly. So if you don't know how to share this, you can just hit the little character in the corner. The replay keeps stopping. It's probably your internet connection. You know, the down command. I don't teach down on day one because it's actually a lot of pressure to put on a dog. It's a lot of pressure to put on a dog. So if you don't have a relationship with a dog and they don't know down, that's a lot of pressure to put on a dog. So we don't teach down on the first day. All right. So if you don't know who I am, solidcaninetraining.com, solidcaninetraining.com, you can go to my website. In general, yeah, I would think it would be hard to find a lot of people to do this. So at our training seminar, we can get everybody to do it. At my training facility, we can get all the staff to do it. You can't exactly have strangers on the streets. But what we can do is I will do the hard work. I'll take the risk of the bite. And then what we can do is we can try to get other people to do it. Once the dog starts thinking of people as not the enemy, then it makes a big difference. It makes a big difference. So the dog now is already, it's actually like going up to people saying, hey, you're pretty cool. So we just went up to Mike to say, hey, you're pretty cool. Hold on, let me just get this on Mike.
So let's see what the interaction is like. Yep, set it up. Always set it up. It's training. Set up is training. So for all my athlete friends out there, you train. You do repetitions, right?
Any other thing. All right. Oh, wow, Mama Hans, that's great. A clown? Clowns scare the shit out of a lot of humans, let alone dogs. Good for you. Oh, awesome. Thank you. Thank you, shelter dog. Yeah. So Jasmine is a shelter employee. We've got a lot of shelter staff here. The primary reason why I'm in Maui right now is to work with shelter staff, but not at the shelter, out of the shelter. Good. Yeah, I mean, my you're clown reactive. Yeah, my wife is definitely afraid of clowns. So my, you know, a lot of shelter, what they do at the shelter is it's just so many dogs are dying. So my videos are pretty neutral. I mean, if you listen to the information on my videos, I think that it's really, really important. So it's really, really important information. And if all you do is focus on the tools, well, here I was using food. So I will get, some people will have negative comments about this. I'm using food and praise. The dog's on a flat collar, but people will say something negative about it because why? Because they're just mean people. That's why. They're just assholes. So an asshole is an asshole. Why would they not be an asshole online? So if you're an asshole online, you're probably an asshole in real life. Okay? So that's why. So you can't be surprised. You can't be surprised by that. All right? So we're out here in Maui, Hawaii. We finished up our first day of the seminar. And tomorrow is our second day. Tomorrow we're going to be doing a lot of group activities. So group healing, pack walking, leash reactivity stuff. We'll be doing all our remote collar baseline stuff. So there'll be a lot of stuff we're doing. We're doing a lot of stuff. Mike's over there having a great time. Mike's making a friend. All right. Let's do some quick questions, some quick Q&A. How was your training for people that have only trained with positive? Yeah, they really enjoyed it. So this is the thing. If you've been to any of my seminars, this is not an ego thing or tooting my own horn. I'm really good at explaining practical concepts to dog owners. Practical concepts to dog owners that just make sense. I tell them to just think about the concepts. So here's a great example. I'll use an example and it involves boobs, okay? So, you know, 80% of my clientele is female. So here's a great example. A jumping dog. A dog jumps on you. It is a very common training practice for when a dog jumps on you, a trainer will say to take food and throw it on the ground. This is actually trained professional dog trainers that say this. When the dog jumps, throw food on the ground. Okay? Think about that. Now, does that make sense? Has anybody ever heard that before? Okay. So Fat Boy Indiana, what you can do is if you can go back and watch the replay. What I did was I already did my dog training demo with an aggressive dog with counter conditioning protocol. And now I'm doing some Q&A. All right. So training the dog to jump. Right. Training the dog to jump. So, awesome, Fat Boy. Good. Good to have you here. Sounds like it's your first time here. Check me out on Solid Canine Training. What I do, Fat Boy Indiana, is I do a training video, and then I do Q&A. You jumped in on the Q&A, so you missed the training part, but you watched it on the replay. Thank you so much for joining in. So, So, I want you to know that two people there were told that when their dog jumps to throw food, Fat Boy Industries, awesome. Thanks for being here, buddy. To throw food on the ground. So this is the example I used. What was her name? The woman whose boobs I was talking about? Janine? Kelly. So a woman named Kelly there. I said, Kelly, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to walk up to you, and I'm going to grab your boobs, and when I do, throw 20s on the ground. Okay? Right? I grab your boobs. Throw 20s on the ground. So what do I do? I stop grabbing her boobs. I pick up the 20s. And then what are we doing? Am I ever going to stop grabbing her boobs? Never. 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 Okay? That's what you're doing with your dogs. If you want to stop a bad behavior, you have to create discomfort. That doesn't mean we're beating or abusing the dogs, because that's a bullshit explanation. Okay? It's a momentary correction. What do? We can do leash correction or remote correction. That's it. It's a 1 second correction. That's it. No yelling, no screaming. You don't throw the dog in a crate, but you don't ignore it. You can't ignore it. So the way I explain things, this makes sense to a lot of people, because it's sort of like, yeah, that doesn't make sense. Why would I reward a dog for doing a bad behavior? Why? Because people that call themselves positive trainers either don't know how to fix the problem, or they're afraid that they might be going against this cult-like religious mantra, which is actually killing dogs. So let me give you another good example here. So the dog just growled. It didn't growl at Mike, growled at another dog. So Jasmine, we'll work on that tomorrow. But this dog is being run. Yep, jumping will always get worse. And I assure you, you start giving me 20s for grabbing boobs, oh, I'm going to be grabbing lots of boobs, right? Even Jasmine thought that was funny. And she's very conservative. She comes from a conservative household. All day, I'm crying all day. Damn right, all day. All day and night. All day and night. Okay. Even CrossFit Mike would do it. He just wouldn't talk about it.
So, let's see. That might be it for today, for tonight. Tomorrow we're going to try to do some other stuff. But actually, Mike snuck in a Periscope. Would I consider the dog insecure? This dog right here, I think there's definitely a little bit of fear. I've seen some really, Mike's rocking the beard. Yeah, he's definitely rocking the beard. At first, when I thought, Mike's retired military, I thought that maybe he was, that photo of him was like back when he was in Afghanistan in Special Forces, because they allow you to grow your beards like that, because he would fit right in. But no, he was actually clean cut back then. And this is his, what island do you live on again?
Oahu.
This is an Oahu beard. He's on Oahu. All right, Braddy. This dog is not, bratty, snotty, definitely insecure. I don't think he's aggressive, but he definitely can be pushed to aggression with too much pressure. Definitely can be pushed to aggression for too much pressure. So what we're doing right now is, and then we're using his hump. So Jasmine, I would pop that leash. No, again.
No.
Yep, no. No, you say no to the dog.
Oh, okay.
No. So every time he wants to, shelters don't approve tools. Oh, Shaq, do me a favor. Stay out of shelters. Okay, Shaq? Stay out of shelters. So, here's a good example.
So, the dog was going towards the fence, going towards there, because he wants to bark at dogs. So what I did was I instructed Jasmine to just pop the leash and say no. And you can say, well, all he was doing is looking. But he was looking, and we're going to let him do that to Mike. That we don't want him to jump on Mike, but guess what though? I like that he's a little bit engaged right now. Don't worry, we're not reinforcing jumping. This is a dog that growls at every human and every dog. All right? So, let's see if he does the bad behavior good little thing. That's cool. Good. So, all right.
Now watch the replay. All right? Mad Hearts. Guys, give me lots of hearts, hit the screen. If you're just tuning in, it's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Also, you can make sure you follow me. Hit the little character on the bottom. If you're watching this live, my bio comes up. Follow me. And then also, you want to make sure you turn on your alerts. And then also, you can swipe and share this. Share this on Facebook. Share this on Twitter. And I will be on the air tomorrow for my morning motivation sunrise edition from Maui, Hawaii, and I go on the air at 6:05 Hawaiian time, which is UK minus 10, which is 6 hour difference from Eastern Standard Time. For your motivation, who needs Sunday morning motivation? What are we going to talk about? Mike's got some good ideas. He gave me a bunch of good ideas. We'll talk about something. All right, I will have a kick-ass day tomorrow, but I will see everybody tomorrow morning. I wake up at 4 in the morning, and I will be on the air at 6. You want me to talk about you, older bird? Sure. I could do that. Did you run today, older bird? You love every morning motivation. Good, everything, Mastiff. You're on, everyone. Thank you so much, buddy. Where's everybody from? Where's everybody from? Just type in where you're from. And after that, give me lots of good hearts. See you later, Shaq. Mike, we gotta go get ice and water and protein. Arizona, Ottawa, nice. Oh, you're from Kailua. I'm on Maui, Northern California. New Zealand, awesome. I'll be in Australia soon. Sleep well. I sleep like a freaking rock star. Thank you. Kailua. K-A-L. I'm bad with these things. Protein. Mike needs protein. What do you mean by that?
Steak.
We've got hamburgers and hot dogs tonight.
I haven't had bacon in 36
hours. She's got bacon here. We might have to take... Are we going to just take the little four-wheel drive vehicle, though, down the hill. All right. Crazy wife. Try the pig. Mike's a local. Mike's a local. So he knows this stuff. He knows all this stuff. So I'm new. It's my first time in Maui. Having a great time. If you haven't seen my morning sunrise periscope, so say no and pop.
Oh.
Beautiful. Beautiful. You see that? What did you just do to the dog? Interrupted it, and you technically corrected it, and you got it to focus on you. So pretty much what you did was, there's nothing out there for you. But you could, Jasmine, you could be like, well, yeah, but he was looking, and he wasn't really barking. But do you think he was thinking, he was thinking naughty thoughts?
Yeah.
So correct big for small infractions. Just remember that. He has a history of growling at everything that moves. And he should be focused on you, not on there. All right? Good. Good job. All right, guys. I love you. I would stay out all night with you. All right? I would stay out all night. Maybe I'll start reading bedtime stories or something. All right? Bedtime stories. Want me to read books? Put everybody to sleep? All right. What's that? Mike's exact words. I would go the fuck to sleep. Oh, yes. Yes, it is. Yes, Samuel Jackson. Yeah. Yes, we've read the book too. We have it for my kids. And my wife bought it. It's Linda for you. She's sick. All right, guys. Madly in love with you. I'll see you tomorrow. Here he is. Sir barks and bites a lot. Pretty incredible, huh?
He'd be a good friend, placing down.
Yeah.
30 minutes, 25 minutes. Just helps calm him down.
Yeah. So this is a dog that associated humans with, I'm going to growl, lunge, and try to bite you. Because I want you to move away. And now here's Mike, who he just met. So this whole concept of it takes a long time to build a relationship, we might want to discuss that. And here's one effing happy owner.
Definitely.
So now you got dogs, so watch the dog's energy change, let's see if it changes. That dog's out there playing hard, and guess what? Your dog is going, huh? So Mike did a little shh, which was because the dog started probably growling. But the dog is definitely not paying as much attention to it. So the dog's priority.